Hello friend! This is a mini tutorial showing you how to take the Steven Universe style logo you made in my main tutorial and apply the new colour scheme from the upcoming movie. It should be nice and quick if you've already followed my other tutorial. So, to follow this tutorial, you'll need Adobe Photoshop, as with the previous tutorial. I'll be using the most recent Creative Cloud version. For a couple of examples on how to use the logo, I'll be using Vegas Pro 15. You'll also need a couple more files that are in the Logo Tutorial Mega or Google Drive folders, which are linked in the description. Follow my previous tutorial, at least 7 minutes in, at which point you've exported two elements of your logo text, a front face like this, and the backing of the logo like this. Open your logo front face image in Photoshop, and then add in the logo backing image as a new layer. Make sure you load them in that order. Drag the backing layer below the front layer so it goes to the back. From the Mega folder under Logo Tutorial, import the image Text Extrusion Colors Movie and drag it to the corner of your Photoshop document out of the way. We're going to start by adding the inlay gradient to the logo text. Right-click on your front face layer and select Blending Options. Add a gradient overlay. It may be in this bottom left FX menu if you haven't used this option before. Click on the current gradient and click the Load button. Open the SU Movie Logo Gradient file, which can be found in the Mega folder linked in the description. Select the new gradient which appears and press OK. If you're unable to import this file for some reason, you can make your own gradient with the two grad colors that are on the color reference image you imported earlier. Make sure your settings are the same as mine here, particularly an angle setting of 270 degrees. Your text should now have a nice gradient inset in the text, like the movie logo. The next thing we need to do is change the colors on the rear text element. Right-click on that element and choose Rasterize Layer. Now choose the Magic Wand Selection tool, set Tolerance to 0, and make sure the three boxes are unticked. Use the Magic Wand tool to select the red color in your backing image. Using the Eyedropper tool, select the left red color from the color reference image under Back. Go to Edit, Fill, make sure Foreground Color is selected, and press OK. Do the same thing with the pink color in your logo backing and the right color from the reference image. Now that the colors are all right, we just need to add a border. Select your two layers and merge them. Right-click on the merged layer and choose Blending Options. Add a stroke. For the color, copy the red color from the backing image. Make sure the settings are the same as mine here and set the stroke size to make your image look like mine. Since my example is in 4K resolution, a 20 pixel stroke looks about right. If your logo is at a different resolution, the stroke width will need to change accordingly. If you want to add something similar to this little bubble that says The Movie on the original logo, we can do that. Choose the Text tool, set the font to Crooniverse, Steven Universe's title card font, linked in the description, and type whatever you want it to say. Use the Tracking setting up here if you want to separate the letters a bit. Right-click on your new text layer and select Blending Options. Select the gradient overlay like before. It should give you the same settings as last time, so all you need to do is check Reverse to flip the direction of the gradient. Find the Rounded Rectangle tool. Set the fill color to the lilac color from your text, make sure stroke is disabled, and set the radius to a really high number. Select whatever layer is below your new text and click and drag to draw the rounded rectangle around the text. Finally, this needs a little red background. So open the blending options for your rectangle and add a drop shadow. For the color, copy the red from your logo text. Set the angle to 135 degrees, size to 0, spread to 100. My distance here is 32, but you may need a different number if your document is a different resolution to mine. Now your logo is complete, you should save and export the logo to a PNG file. You can then use the transparent PNG file in whatever manner you like. Put it on a still background, like the textless poster image I provided in the mega folder, or you could use it in a video. Moving on to videos. As I said earlier, for an example of video usage, I'm going to use Vegas Pro 15. Any other version should be fine, though I can't vouch for anything before version 13. First, we're going to go through a method for the movie teaser from last year. If you want to skip ahead to the method for the more recent movie trailer, go to the timestamp shown on screen now. Go to the mega folder under textless trailers and download the textless movie teaser and the two overlay videos. Open Vegas Pro and drag the textless teaser video onto the timeline. If it asks whether to match the project settings, say yes. Find the last frame in the video where the screen is completely white and place a marker. Get your completed logo PNG and drag it onto a new video track on the timeline at this point. Move along to the first frame where the screen has completely stopped glowing and place another marker. Stay in line with this second marker and open the track motion window for the track with your logo on it. Make sure the sync cursor option is selected. Now you need to resize and rotate your logo in a similar manner to how the official one appears in the trailer. Once you've done that, copy the keyframe you've just made and move your timeline cursor to the starting point for your logo PNG event. On the track motion window, right-click where the timeline cursor is and paste the keyframe. Scale the logo up on this keyframe to make it larger than the screen, then right-click on the current keyframe and select Fast. Your logo should now appear in frame in a similar manner to how the background animates. Now you need to go to the Event FX for your logo PNG. Add the levels and glow effects in that order. These may appear as either Vegas levels or Sony levels, depending on which version of Vegas you're using. On the levels effect, choose the preset Computer RGB to Studio RGB. This makes your logo PNG stop looking oversaturated compared to everything else. For the glow effect, start by entering the following values: glow percent 0.1, intensity 6, and suppression 0. You also need to change the color to white. Now, you need to toggle the animate on for the intensity and suppression settings, and go to the point where the logo has stopped moving on the timeline. Click the button here to create a new keyframe, so the glow effect becomes animated. On this keyframe, change the intensity to 0.8 and the suppression to 0.15. Your logo should now fade in from a pure white glow while it resizes into frame. Now that the logo part of this video is in place, we need to add the two kinds of sparkles to the video. So create two new video tracks above your logo. We'll start with the bokeh effect. This video should be placed on the track above your logo, and the start point should be two frames before your logo has stopped moving. Right-click on the bokeh event and click Properties. Move to the Media tab and change the alpha channel to pre-multiplied. Click OK, then go to the track's compositing mode and select Dodge. That one's done. Add the star overlay video to the second new video track and place it so it starts two frames after your logo PNG appears. Again, change this media's alpha channel to pre-multiplied. That's all you need to do for that one. Finally, make sure your logo PNG event ends at the same time as the bokeh sparkles, and do something to make everything fade out together. I tend to just add a black solid color event over the top of everything else and fade it in. Now you have this project set up, you can reuse it for different logos simply by duplicating the track with your logo on it and right-click dragging a different logo PNG over, then selecting Add as Takes. This will replace the PNG on the event while leaving everything else in place, including the effects and motion. Just for completion's sake, this teaser did have some text after showing the movie logo, so if you wanted to include something like that in your edit, you can simply trim down the logo event and add some text after it on a new video track. It looks similar to the Crooniverse font, which MaxiGamer made to copy the Steven Universe title card style, so you can use that and a similar colour to easily add some text to your video. After your teaser clone is finalised, you just need to render it off. In Vegas Pro 15 or later, you'll have a Magix AVC/AAC MP4 as an output format. This works well for YouTube and is quick to export. In earlier versions, you'll have the main concept AVC/AAC MP4, which has all the same output settings. Just make sure the frame rate and resolution match the project settings, which should be 23.976 frames per second and 1920 by 1080 pixels, and use YouTube's suggested bitrate settings. Right, now we've covered the teaser, it's time to go over a usage demonstration for the trailer. This one doesn't need any special extra assets like the bokeh and stars from the teaser, but you will need to go back to Photoshop and add an extra white stroke to your logo. So, open your logo PNG in Photoshop, not your original PSD Photoshop document this time, and go to the blending options for the single layer which appears. Add a stroke, make it pure white, with settings copying mine on screen here. For the size, we actually want this white outline to be pretty big, so at 4K resolution, mine is 64 pixels wide. As with previous sizing suggestions, your miles may vary based on your document resolution. Start a new project in Vegas Pro and add the video file SU Movie Trailer Textless Logo Section Only from my asset folder to your timeline. Look through the video and find the first frame where the screen goes almost entirely white, like this. Drop in your logo with the big white outline on a new track at this point. Find the point where the screen goes black and make your logo event end there. Use the track motion window with sync cursor switched on and resize the logo so it starts off small, then scales up within several frames. Right-click on the first keyframe and set it to fast so it scales smoothly. The next part in the trailer was a date rendered in the same logo style. You could make another set of text with a date or something else and put it here if you like. I just made some that says other words because I'm too lazy to think of anything. Place this on a new track and get it to start just after the whole screen flashes white and get it to end at the next white flash. This needs to go from small to big over its entire appearance, so we're going to open the event pan crop and use this to scale the image down. So click the event pan crop, go to the first keyframe, make it very small, then go to the end of the clip and make it a bit bigger. If you want to give this a little shiny to go across it, duplicate the track. On the top one, add the effect HSL adjust and increase the luminance to maximum. Click on its event pan crop and turn the mask on. With the start of the event selected, that's its left edge, draw a rectangle mask that touches the left edge of the text. Change its feather type to in and set the percentage to 5%. Now move 12 frames, that's half a second, along the mask timeline and place another keyframe. Move to 1 second on the mask timeline and create another keyframe again. On this keyframe, move the rectangle you've made so it touches the right edge of the text. You should now have a white streak that moves across the text shortly after it appears. There's one more effect on this text. Light rays appear to come out of it just before it disappears. If you want to recreate this part, add the effect rays to the text on the lower track. This may appear as either Sony rays or Vegas rays, depending on the version you're using. Move to the last frame before this text event ends. Change the settings to match mine here. The ones you need to change are the threshold to the minimum of 25, the amount to 37, the positions to 50, the peak to 150, saturation to 0, and quality to 80. Your text should now have rays of light beaming out of it, looking something like this. Click the Animate button here, make sure the sync cursor is selected, and click on Add Keyframe. Now go back 8 frames and add another keyframe. On this keyframe, drag the amount down to zero and move the threshold up to the maximum. It may have made a keyframe at the start by default, so make sure you right-click on that and delete it if it's there. Your text should now have a kind of light rays transition, like mine here. After this bit, there's a series of text elements appearing along with the music. You can add this by either planning out a layout in Photoshop and exporting each text element individually, or you can create text events directly in Vegas and try to position them manually there. I think the Photoshop method might be easier, so I'm going to quickly do that in my example. The font you'll need is Haruko Black, which I've linked in the description. This is all just making and positioning text, so I'm not going to explain in detail. You should be able to figure this part out pretty easily if you have a basic grasp of these two tools. Just so you know, if you import a PSD from Photoshop directly into Vegas by right-click dragging, the option Add Across Tracks will come up, which will allow you to paste every layer of your Photoshop document to a new video track. This will make it very quick to add each text element to a new video track. I placed markers on the timeline by ear here when I could hear it one of the tones in the music, and then revealed one piece of text for each marker. The final element shows the heart gem, which in the trailer had the Cartoon Network logo reflected in it. If you like, just throw in a logo for yourself in there, why not? After your trailer clone is finalized, you just need to render it off. In Vegas Pro 15 or later, you'll have Magic's AVC/AAC MP4 as an output format. This works really well for YouTube and is quick to export. In earlier versions, you'll have the main concept AVC/AAC MP4, which has all the same output settings. Just make sure the frame rate and resolution match the project settings, which should be 23.976 frames per second and 1920 by 1080 pixels, and use YouTube's suggested bitrate settings. Sorry if you caught me repeating myself there, just in case some people follow one video method and not the other, that little explanation needed to be at the end of both. That's all I have to show you for today. If you've enjoyed or made some use out of this video, please like, subscribe, do a comment, share with your best friend Alan, all of those things. If you really like this, please consider donating via PayPal or supporting my work monthly via Patreon. You can see a list of my current patrons here. What amazing people they are. Love you, bye bye.